Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
So let's start with the obvious. Hooking up one of these motors requires working with electricity. And if you don't know what you're doing and you hook something up incorrectly, or you touch something that you shouldn't touch when the power is on, it can kill you. Use this information at your own risk.
So a discussion came up on the Facebook mill lathe combo machine page about adding a brake to your lathe. And some talked about using a bicycle brake on the motor, and some talked about putting a brake on the spindle itself. I'm here to show you that if you've converted your lathe to a treadmill motor, it technically comes with a brake. So the first question is, why do we even need a brake? Well, let's go ahead and turn this on for a second. I'm not going to turn it up to full speed. And then I'm going to shut it off. And we're going to sit here and wait as it spins down. Now, normally when this is installed, you would have the weight of the spindle and you would have belts and pulleys and other things that would cause it to slow down a lot more quickly. But still, it does take a while to slow down. At max speed, my lathe takes between 7 and 8 seconds to fully come to a stop. Well, good, we're finally getting there. Let me give it a little help. So you can see why there would be an advantage in having a brake. So I said in my opening that a treadmill motor technically comes with a brake, and that would be accessed by adding this right here. This is an on-on double pole double throw switch. If you hook this up correctly to this, it will act as a brake. So the way a double pole double throw switch works is these two center terminals are what I would call the common terminals. They're going to something. And then when it switched one direction, you get a connection from here to here. And when it switched the other direction, you get a connection from here to here. And the same is true of the other side. So the way I have this wired, if we take these two center terminals, black and red, and we hook them up to the motor, and then we take these two outside terminals, black and red, and we hook them up to the power supply. Then on this other side, this is where the braking action happens. We have two green wires, and I have those wires shorted out across each other. Now, the reason I did that is because when a treadmill motor like this is free spinning, it switches from being a motor to being a generator. The same type action that turns electricity into motion, when no electricity is being applied, turns motion back into electricity. So by creating a direct short, we draw all the energy out of the system, and the flywheel will come to a quick stop. Let me get this wired up and I'll give you a demonstration. All right, so the switch is wired up. Let's turn this all the way down. Let's fire this up and see what happens. All right, so it's coming on. We'll get some good speed. Then we'll throw the switch. You can hear it come to a stop. Now, what you could not see is that there was a flash here at the back of the motor, and that is because of the brushes arcing where they make contact with the motor, because we took all that energy and we shunted it out immediately. But this shows that this is an effective way to create an emergency stop. And in the case of a lathe, if you are already at reduced speed because of loads, that stop will be almost instantaneous. Now, if only there was a way that we could accomplish the same thing, reduce the wear and tear on the motor, and still get it to stop, But wait, there is. Instead of doing a direct short, like I have here, if we attach this to a very large resistor, that will slightly limit the flow of electricity and will accomplish the same thing, create the braking action, but reduce the wear and tear on the brushes inside the motor. So let's talk about resistors for a minute. If you use the tiny little component type resistor for a project like this that are usually rated at less than 1 watt, you're gonna just burn it up. The purpose of the resistor is to convert electrical energy into heat. And we're creating quite a bit of electrical energy from the free spinning of the treadmill motor. So you need a high wattage resistor. This is a 1,000 watt resistor at 4 ohms. Now, the important thing to know about resistors is if you wire them in series, you end up adding their values. If you wire them in parallel and they start out at the same value, you'll cut the values in half. If you take a 4 ohm resistor and you take a 10 ohm resistor and you wire them in series, so in, out, you're gonna end up with 14 ohms. But if you take a 4 ohm resistor and a 10 ohm resistor and you wire them in parallel, you'll only end up with slightly less than 4 ohms. It's not gonna cut it in half. The math is more complicated at that point. Now, if they are matched, if I take this 4 ohm resistor and this 4 ohm resistor and we wire them in parallel, now we get a resistance of 2 ohms, which is gonna dissipate the energy from the free spinning motor quite a bit quicker.
So here's the challenge. Here's the balance that we need to reach. You want the motor to stop as quickly as it can while having the minimum amount of wear and tear on the brushes inside. So we're gonna do a direct comparison with the 4 options we have to slow this motor down. First, with no braking. Second, with a 4 ohm resistor, then a 2 ohm resistor, and then finally, no resistor. I've got the power supply set up at half speed. For most shop tools, most things you would be using a setup like this, you're not gonna have this at wide open max most of the time. More often than not, you're gonna be somewhere in the middle. So I figured this was the best place to set it up for this project. So, first, with no brake of any kind. That was right around 40 seconds. Now let's see where we come in with a 4 ohm resistor. It's about 10 seconds. So we've cut the slowdown time into 1/4. Now with a 2 ohm resistor. Pretty close to 7 seconds. So we've shaved about 3 seconds off. And now finally, no resistor, a direct short across the leads. It's right around 4 seconds. So we've gone from 40 seconds down to 4 seconds. Now keep in mind, this is all a bench test. There is no resistance to this flywheel. We are not running belts or other pulleys, other things that would slow this down. I'm gonna take these 2 resistors and I'm gonna hook them up to my lathe at the 2 ohm resistance. And we will do a comparison. We'll see how long it takes to stop with no resistor. We'll see how long it takes to stop with the 2 ohm resistor. I'm not actually gonna do the direct short. That's the best motor I have on that lathe, and I don't wanna do anything to jeopardize its long-term life. So here's the comparison of no braking resistor and with a braking resistor on my lathe. I have the lathe speed set at about 1,000 RPMs. It's a little more than half, so different from the bench test. I wanted to push it a little more for this test. I felt like that was just a good number. You know, typically I'm not going faster than 1,000 RPMs. And I also wanted it to be going a little faster so that we could have a little better comparison. So first, we have without the resistor. It's about 3.5 seconds. Now with the resistor. It's right around a second. So here's the two side by side. For me, getting it to slow down in a second or less is amazing. That's 4 times quicker. That's something that I can use when I'm threading so that when I get to the gutter, I can stop things quickly. But I also know that I'm dissipating that energy slow enough that I'm not going to damage the motor.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.